to Bluegrass on Stage. I'm Patty Williams. This show is a live performance of the Byron Goes Bluegrass concert series from the VanSingle Fine Arts Center, featuring the multi-award-winning bluegrass band, Mountain Heart. So grab a seat and let's get picking. Mountain Heart is on stage.
So keep those hands going and please welcome Mountain Heart.
We Thank you. not Jim Van Cleve on the fiddle tonight. Jimmy is currently giving birth to his first child. He's back in Nashville, and he's within in hours of his wife giving birth, and we just couldn't stand taking 12, 13 hours away from home and her that close. So Mike Cleveland was gracious enough to come right in here, and I don't even know that he knew any of our material, but he just jumped right in here and goes for it. And yeah. As soon as we got him in school for a year all these times, we're just so excited. He said, "Been on fire." I get goosebumps when he starts playing. Me and Michael's been talking about cutting a record ourselves, and maybe getting Doc Watson and Bradley Walker and a few others on it, and just don't know what we're going to title it, but it's going to kind of be a Gimps and Blind Man's record, and it's going to be good, so you better be waiting on it. It's amazing. He's just an amazing person. I'm going to go ahead and introduce him first, playing that tune out there. It was written by Jim Van Cleve and just wore out by Michael Cleveland. Charlestown, Indiana, one of the greatest of all time. Mr. Michael Cleveland, thank you, brother. We can't tell how much we appreciate him doing this. We had a false alarm a couple weeks ago, and Jim had to miss one show, and we did it without a fiddle player. And it's pretty boring. It looked pretty bad without a fiddle player. On the mandolin, he is the 5-time world heavyweight champion of the mandolin at the International Bluegrass Music Award. He doesn't have no music. Here it comes. You like this one, Jeff. I'm really good. I know you just don't do that. You go to the finger. Yeah, it's a finger joke coming up here. He gets to win one more award, maybe one and a half, and somebody else is going to have to introduce him. I can't count on higher than 6 or 4. He's from Kingsport, Tennessee, and he's one of our best buddies and the finest man on the picture ever holding on. Mr. Adam Steffey, make him welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much, and welcome out to the show tonight. We're tickled to death to be up here. It's been a while since we've been over in this part of Michigan. We get over around Ann Arbor a bunch and play at the Ark, and we're going to be back over there and not too distant future. I think after the first of the year, but it's fun to get back over here and play. Get to see a lot of familiar faces and a lot of folks we don't get to see very often. And one of our old buddies from over around just outside Detroit, and one of our best buddies that we've met out here. And you meet a lot of great folks playing music and running up that road, but you can't beat one of our best friends from out here, Michigan, Greg Purtle, who is over tonight. But to see him and all you folks, thank you so much. They told us there was going to be this many people here. We walked in here and saw all these seats, and we said, "Oh, Lord, we're going to have a you hear crickets here today." But they said, "No, we're going to be a big crowd." So we really appreciate you coming out and spending part of the Saturday evening with us. We know you can be home watching CSI Grand Rapids. One of those designing shows where they come by and fix your house up while you come see a bluegrass show. So, you never know, they might be there fixing yours up right now. Stealing something, as it were. But we appreciate you so much for coming out. I'll go ahead and get one more introduction out of the way. The fellow right here playing rhythm guitar, and he's without a doubt. They don't have a category for this, but I've been around bluegrass for about, running up down the road for about 25 years, and that is definitely the hairiest man in bluegrass music. He can sprout a guy on out there. We're all thinking about getting transplants to the top of our head. All the Steve right there, because he's calling Chia Steve. He just had diet coke. He sprouts right here on the stage. He was clean shaven when we started rehearsing, although, and you see what's happened so far. So. Yeah, and every now and then he lets that top button go. Don't have a t-shirt on under it, too. He's in there. Just guys and nuts. Looks like it's a raccoon strap t-shirt. With a nice gold chain, but the folks we're going to get up here to do a number we get a lot of requests for, and we've probably already had some folks ask for this. I'm not double checked, but we get them every night because this is one of the most we get requests for. And this fellow's going to sing for you. He's from Gap, Tennessee. It's Mr. Steve Gully back there on the guitar. Thank you.
Step right up. Come on in. If you Thank you. train gonna be headed. Wow, wow.
Folks, you gotta give a big hand to the Mountain Park Bluegrass Nose Horn around here. You get jealous of that. You don't know how it feels to have to stand up here and blow your nose on a microphone in front of people overnight.
Oh, sinner man, won't you please ride this train? You better set your house in order, friend. You know the train gonna be here tonight.
Oh, no, man.
On its way to glory, you know the train gonna be here tonight. My Lord, she blows. Wow!
Oh, wow!
mean, he's amazing. He's more every time I get to pick with him. I first met Michael, I believe, I can't remember when it was. You came down to the Opry. You remember that, Michael?
Yeah, that
was back in the 40s, right?
1840s.
There you go. I feel like it was the 1840s. I'll tell you what, but this fellow come in, and I don't know if you played Opry before or not, but I remember we sat back in there. We were in the dressing room jamming. This was one of our thousand crowds several years ago. And I remember he came in, and we sat back there, and just we played, but we couldn't hardly pick them over. And we got out on stage, and he absolutely tore it down. And I've never seen him do anything but that ever since then. I've had the opportunity to share the stage with him a few times, not really often enough, and we keep thanking him that once again for filling in for Jimmy while he's at home awaiting the birth of his youngin'. And we're just taking a look at that this fellow was able to come and do it. We're going to turn it loose right now. If I can bring you this team, I'm going to put you on the field.
Thank you.
hurts my hand just to look at it. But this guy right here is definitely one of the best to ever hold a bass. And it's a pleasure to stand next to him every night and try and hang on with it. He lays it in there, and we're right there. We just try and hang with him because we think he's the best. And I'm sure y'all are enjoying that part of the show. He sings a little bit, picks a little bit, works on the bus a lot more than he wants to, but he's awful good at that, too. Thank you, Mom. If you would, that's just more on the bus. Each and every album out of our show is a man who's he's one of the meekest, most gentle fellas you'll ever meet anywhere. But when he gets that guitar and starts picking, as you can tell, it looks like he's about to rip it in half. It's like he's made of mad, and he's whipping it for years of bad conduct. So, but I'm telling you, he is definitely, I've known him just probably about 20 years, something like that. I hadn't been playing too awful long when I first saw this fellow down in North Carolina Festival. And he was walking around looking for a jam session. He had a guitar strapped around. He didn't have a shirt on, no shoes, but he had a pair of shorts. And he was walking around the Bluegrass Festival, and it's about 105. And he had his guitar like Johnny Cash, you know, he's walking there. All right, who's going to pick next? And buddy, I guarantee you, he's been praying ever since. He's like Michael Cleveland down there. They've got one gear and it's on. When they're awake, they're ready to go, folks. And this guy right here, he's working hard for you. And don't let him scare you. He's, like I say, he's going to be nice as well as you'll ever need. But don't get pointed in that guitar when it comes time for a solo to end because he's going to make that face. So, thank you, Buckley, if you would, from over in Knoxville, North Carolina. That's one of the best, Blake Jones.
Folks, we got a ball with you tonight at Byron's Intermission. Our first trip up this way, and we hope to goodness it's not our last. You've made us feel so welcome that we felt at home all evening. And I thank all the folks responsible for putting this show on and finally getting us up this way. Give them a nice hand of applause. Thank you. Thank you. And on behalf of all the guys in the band and our brother Jim Vanderfleet at home, we want to thank a special thank you to one of the finest musicians I've ever had the chance to get on stage with, and I mean that sincerely. He came in there with no notice, in the middle of the night, jumped on the bus about 4 or 5 o'clock this morning and took out and came up here and played with little or no rehearsal on anything, and just absolutely killed him. Nice hand for old buddy from the Indiana, that's Mr. Michael Hogan. Nice hand for Michael. If you're ready, Michael, go home, Lee Highway. You ready, Lee?